In my first video about CPPC in superposition, I asked if you wanted me to test it in real games too. Only one viewer answered, Naksur, who suggested to choose a CPU-intensive and a GPU-intensive game. Since, as you can see, I completely missed the second wish, I've just chosen a game that's known to be quite CPU-dependent and has a built-in benchmark. Assassin's Creed Origins, in its alternative version. The Discovery Tour of Ancient Egypt. As for the graphics settings, unlike Superposition and CSGO, where I forced a CPU-bound scenario by reducing resolution and quality, here I maxed them all out. After all, in single-player games most people prefer eye candy, not potato. Anyway, I ran the benchmark 10 times for each CPPC combination and wrote down minimum, average, maximum FPS and total frames. Now, two simple graphs to depict them all. The first shows the average min, AVG and max FPS in every condition. It seems that CPPC off-off and on-off both worsen the min and max by a few frames, while they improve the average by just one frame. However, in the second graph, we can notice that off-off and on-off respectively deliver an average of about 60 and 40 more total frames than on-on. One way to find out if these differences in total frames and mean FPS are statistically significant is the usual ANOVA. I've excluded max and AVG FPS from it, because the former are of no interest, and the latter are 103 versus 104. I've said enough. So let's perform the ANOVA on the minimum FPS first. Unbroken assumptions? Check. Descriptive statistics? Check. Null and alternative hypotheses? Check. Since RStudio returns a p-value sample of 0.188, each zero is accepted. The difference between these averages is not statistically significant. Finally, let's repeat it on the total frames. Unbroken assumptions? Descriptive statistics, two hypotheses, triple check. RStudio returns a p-value sample of 0.104, so H0 is, once again, accepted. To recap, Assassin's Creed Origins does not exhibit any CPPC effect. From a statistical point of view, its performance will be equal with each of the three combos. On my Ryzen 3700X, at least. And that is indeed the catch. The benchmark results may be heavily influenced by the CPU model, or perhaps even its specific sample. In fact, the order of the best cores varies from one to another. Unfortunately, I cannot verify such a theory, as I only own this processor. Thanks for watching and farewell for now.